But in the presence of, while the ligands are going to added to these metal complexes, the energy increases, the energy of d orbitals increases. It is called as degeneracy state of d orbitals. So how many lines? 5 lines. Each line indicate one type of d orbital: dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square, yz, dz square. Now, while those ligands are going to approach towards this, out of the 5 d orbitals, whatever the d orbital present onto the axis, that means dx square, y square, dz square orbital present onto the axis. So those dx square, y square, dz square orbital which present onto the axis will face strong repulsion with upcoming ligand. Hence, the energy of those ligands, or sorry, energy of those orbitals increases and enters into EG level. Similarly, the remaining 3 orbitals like dxy, dyz, dzx cannot face stronger repulsions with upcoming ligand and enters into less energetic T2G level. Dxy, dyz, dzx enters here, where dx square, y square, dz square enters into higher energy level. This is the energy of the orbital at degeneracy. Here, this the energy gap present in between EG and T2G is represented as delta O, where delta is equals to energy gap, O stands for octahedral complexes. In this octahedral complexes, due to more repulsion with upcoming ligands, dx square, y square, dz square orbitals occupies higher energetic EG level, where dxy, dyz, dzx orbital reaches lower energetic T2G level, and the energy difference between this is indicated with delta 0. Here we can represent it as 3 by 5 delta O, but it is 2 by 5 delta O. That is, the energy difference is 3 and energy difference is 2 parts. So this is about splitting of d orbitals in octahedral complexes. So based on this, first we have to know spectrochemical series of ligands. It is the most important condition. So what is spectrochemical series of ligands? The spectrochemical series of ligands explains, it is useful to explain the strength of ligands. As per our previous cases of VBT, valency bond theory, in the presence of some type of ligands, electron pairing takes place. But in case of some type of ligands, electron pairing not expected in the metal complexes or metal ion present in the metal complexes. That means, in the presence of strong field ligand, electron pairing takes place due to more repulsion between d orbital electrons and ligands. Whereas in case of weak field ligand, there is no much expected repulsions between metal complex d orbital electrons and this. So hence, which can offer this? Similarly, VBT is failed to explain which ligands are strong field ligands and which ligands are weak field ligands. But here there is an expectation from the spectrochemical series of ligands, we can expect which are strong field ligands and which are weak field ligands. Let us write the spectrochemical series. Iodide is a weak field ligand, then bromide, then sulfide S-2, then SCN-, then Cl-, then F-, then OH-, then C2O4-2 oxalato, then water, then NCS-, then ammonia is less than ethylene diamine, is less than CN minus, is less than CO. So this is the most important series. What is this? Electrochemical series of ligand. This electrochemical series of ligand is useful to identify which is weak field ligand and which is strong field ligand. That means it is useful to explain the strength of the ligand. So let us consider once again these ligands which are present at initial stages: iodide, bromide, sulfide, thiocyanide, chloride, fluoride, OH. So these ligands are considered to be weak field ligand, whereas after the water or after the ammonia, from the ammonia, then these are isothiocyanide, ammonia, ethylene diamine, cyanide and carbonyls. These are considered as strong field ligands. So these are weak field ligand, these are strong field ligand. That means among available ligands, some of the used as or some of the are strong field, some of them are weak field, e.g. dx square, y square and dg square, two orbitals. So hence two lines. Here is the three orbitals in T2G level. Hence we have to represent this with three lines. Next, the most important condition to explain here is, for example, in degeneracy state only three electrons present. Those three electrons actually went to D. One electron enters into DXY, another electron enters into DYZ, another electron enters into DZX. So in such case, all the orbitals with single electrons. But if the given metal complex or in the given metal ion D4 configuration present, in such case, first three electrons enters into T2G level. We can directly write it as T2G level. That means out of the four, first electron enters into DXY, second electron enters into DYZ, third electron enters into DZX. But what about the fourth electron? There are two possibilities for fourth electron. What are the two possibilities? The fourth electron may enters into DXY and pairs with already existing electron, or second one, the fourth electron may also enters into higher energetic EG level and enters into DX square Y square orbital. So that is the most important category here is, if D4, D5, D6 electron configurations are identified to be present with the metal complexes, the first three electrons easily enters into T2G energy level because of three orbitals present. When the fourth electron, it depends upon what is the probability of fourth electron. Fourth electron will have probability to enters into T2G level, or it enters into higher energetic EG level. So there is some confusion which will take place. The fourth electron, is it enters into T2G level or is it enters into EG level? It depends upon, this will depends upon strength of the ligand. So it is the most important one. So here the two conditions we are going to take, delta 0. What is delta O here? Delta O stands for